sexual state projection. And the idea here comes from NLP, neuro-linguistic programming, and the idea is go first. Any state that you want someone else to feel, if you're in that state, it's going to make it very easy. So if I'm very animated and excited and up like this, it's very easy for someone else to get their energy up. If, on the other hand, I'm very slow, relaxed, sensual, it's going to make it very easy for them to become slow, relaxed, sensual, etc. So the idea here is that if you want someone else to experience a state of sexual arousal, you should be in a state of sexual arousal yourself. So what I suggest is actually calm down a little bit. Well, actually get aroused while calming down, slow down a little bit, objectify them a little bit, imagine sexual things happening, sort of like if whatever turns you on. If you're a boob man, like look at their boobs a little bit. If you like the noises during sex, imagine her moaning. Whatever it is that gets you aroused, allow yourself to fantasize just a little bit in the back of your mind while you're talking. Allow yourself to be in that sexual state. All right, and this will sort of like bring your physiology to a place of, you know, your eyelids will droop a little bit, your voice will slow down, you become more mellow, more relaxed, you'll tend to look in her eyes more, that sort of stuff. And all that on a subconscious level is going to make her sort of follow that state as well. So that's the first technique, is put yourself in the state you want her in. In this case, that would be a sexual one. The second technique for creating sexual tension is maintain eye contact and allow for pauses. Okay, most guys, when they talk to girls, especially hot girls, if they hold eye contact for even a half a second too long, they're immediately darting their eyes away as if like not to get caught staring, right? It's okay. It's okay to be a man. It's okay to have a penis. It's okay to have desire, and it's okay to stare at a girl. Secondly, the pauses. A lot of times if there's any kind of like pause or awkwardness in the conversation, people are so quick to fill it in to try and release and relieve that awkwardness. Awkwardness is a good thing. All right, sexual tension, sexual attraction, a lot of it feels very much like awkwardness. So if you're killing that awkwardness or not allowing her to fill it in and her to chase you, you're reducing one of the most powerful tools that you have at your disposal. The third technique that I want to teach you is called two steps forward, one step back. And the idea here is that you don't have to sexualize all at once. It's better if it's done in little increments. So if you were to walk up to a girl and your first attempt to make it man to woman was like, hey, I want to fuck you, and that's not going to work very well. That's too blatant. That's too brazen. And it's very likely to receive a harsh rejection. If instead they're like, hey, you know what? You're actually quite cute. And then what you're going to do is you're going to calibrate. If she responds positively, you can keep going. If she responds negatively or seems a little uncomfortable, then you would chill out, back off, and only try again later. So instead of trying to do everything in one move, you want to do it in a lot of little moves. And they call it two steps forward, one step back, to make you kind of understand that there is going to be some forward progression, some backward progression, and that's fine. There will be some like, okay, cool, it's going well. Oh, wait, not so much. Take a step back. Breathe, relax, release the tension, and then recreate the tension. By doing it that way, you allow yourself to try a lot of different things and never really face a rejection. So you have the freedom to make a lot of moves. And that's the most important thing, is making a move. It's not that you make one huge move, it's you make one little move, and the next little move, and the next little move. Be patient with your advances. The fourth and final technique I want to share with you is called the phase shift. And this is like your power move, and it actually combines a few of the other concepts. What the phase shift is basically, if you've gotten to a point where it's gone far too long without becoming man to woman, far too long without escalating, or if you need to get a specific escalation movement, like you really know, like maybe it's coming towards the end of a date and you really need to kiss a girl, something like that, that's when you're gonna use the phase shift. So the phase shift is basically you make a strong decision, something's gonna happen, and you just, through the force of your frame, make it happen, all right? So it's like maybe the interaction's all bubbly and all over the place, and you just go, shh. You make eye contact, you slow down, you get close, maybe you cut the distance, and that's when you're gonna kiss. And if she starts talking, right, talking and like relieving the tension, you might just like, no, or shh, right? And you just make that the frame. You just commit to a very sexual frame in that moment, to the point where it would be awkward if she didn't follow you, okay? So that's the phase shift. And the thing about it is you want to pick your time, because you kind of, you're throwing the switch, you're going very hard, and you're making a commitment. This will escalate now. And you'll be surprised, you'll be shocked how well it works and how often you will be able to escalate by doing it. And this does sound like a very risky move, but think of it this way. Anytime that you do the phase shift, it doesn't work, you probably didn't have that much going on anyway, so there wasn't really that much to lose. So this is your escalation power move. You flip the switch, phase shift down to that sexual state, and you basically force her to follow you there. So each of those four techniques should help you massively with making things sexual, making it man to woman, avoiding that platonic interaction. But I want to remind you, the most important thing is the attitude and the desire to do it. No technique in the world is going to help you if you're too scared. Understand, and this is for me personally, I've never lost a girl by trying to escalate, trying to kiss. I have lost lots by missing my window and not trying. And that's because anytime you do this the right way and it doesn't work, it wasn't going to work anyway. All right, so don't view it as risky. View it as a natural part of the dance, a natural part of getting another girl, and something that you have to do as a man. You have to have that attitude of taking action, being willing to take a risk. And then all these techniques are going to make it so, so easy for you. Hey, excuse me. What's up? I'm glad you're still here.
Sorry?
I said, I'm glad you're still here. I had to shoot this video. I was in a rush, so I didn't have a chance to talk to you, but I'm glad you're here because you're very cute. So what is your story in New York?
Modeling.
Okay. Yeah. Are you enjoying it?
Yeah.
So I have a question for you. Are you adventurous and fun, or are you very much like stay at home and read and watch TV? I feel like I watch Real Housewives.
It depends.
It depends?
Yeah, I like to do both.
You know, okay. So, let's see. Coffee, smoothie, or alcohol? What's your pleasure in general? I would say milkshake, but that'd be like 3 days worth of like calories for you, so no.
I like milkshake.
All right. All right, what is your number?
917.